A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th March, on the front page you have travel from EU-UK banned as India tightens preventive steps. So all from UAE, Qatar, Oman, Kuwait would be quarantined, and coronavirus cases across the country has now touched 114. So this is the travel curbs which have been imposed. And this is regarding Madhya Pradesh. So Kamal Nath, Chief Minister, Congress Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh, has ruled out floor test, and he defies Governor Lalji Tandon's directive and claims majority. So this is now our Supreme Court has been approached to urgently hear a petition filed by former Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan and 9 other BJP MLA seeking holding of a vote of confidence. Then this is investors get poorer by 7.62 lakh crores. So investors' wealth has been eroded to this extent due to coronavirus. So you can see another Sensex fall has been witnessed. Then this is in Delhi, public gatherings over 50 are not allowed. Nightclubs, gyms, spas have been shut till March 31. And now this is regarding telecom companies. This is an important news. It says in U-turn, government moves 20-year window to clear telco dues. So nearly 5 months after winning its legal battle in Supreme Court against telecom companies over the adjusted gross revenue dues, central government has now done a virtual U-turn and has urged the court to give the companies a 20-year window to pay the money back. You should remember, Supreme Court had also put forth a deadline. It's October 24, 2019 judgment. But now you can see an application mentioned for urgent hearing in Supreme Court. Government says that after detailed and long-drawn deliberations, it has devised a formula to soften the blow of that judgment, which had directed companies to pay these dues in 3 months. Government wants to give them 20 years. Because we have seen it's a huge amount which is due now, because they had not been paying over the years while the case was being heard. And this is a transgender football team from Manipur. So it will host the country's first team of trans men. So this is called Queer Games. On page 6 you have Arunachal puts off survey of road through Tiger Reserve. So this is a proposal for having a road built through Pakti Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. So the project had attracted criticism from wildlife activists, film personalities and political leaders. So now Arunachal Pradesh government has decided to put this project in abeyance. The survey work which was proposed is in abeyance now. It will not be done for now. It was a part of it was actually a 40 kilometer stretch which was to be built, which was part of the east-west industrial corridor road. And you can see this Pakke Tiger Reserve is a biodiversity hotspot and is part of the eastern Himalayas. So this project has now been shelved. On page 9 you have India still in second transmission stage. So senior scientists and health officials have said that India currently is showing no evidence of any community transmission, and enough tests were being done to pick up an early indication of third stage transmission. So first stage transmission is directly the person has contracted the disease. Second stage is when you have been in contact with a person who has contracted the disease and you have been affected. Third stage transmission within the country would be who has been affected by somebody else now been affected. That has so far not been confirmed in the country, is what has been stated. On the editorial page, the first editorial is back to SAARC. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi did well to engage with leaders of SAARC on combating coronavirus. So that has been appreciated here. He also announced a SAARC fund to deal with coronavirus in SAARC and put forth contribution from India as such too. We have seen that. So such regional organizations need to be revived. And this is fight for the finite. So this is regarding health budgetary allocation in India. That editorial says that this must go up if India is to be prepared for unprecedented epidemic which we are seeing presently too in the form of coronavirus. And the lead article is from virtual conferencing to real leadership. So SAARC video conference had taken place, and now this article says that India has a chance to step up the SAARC video conference as its assertive expression to stabilize the nation. So SAARC actually went was sidelined because the SAARC summit was to be held in Islamabad and India refused to participate in the last SAARC summit, and finally other nations also backed out and the summit was cancelled and it has not been conducted since then. So this was the video conference being conducted now. So that shows a way of going ahead too. And this is a crisis hit Iran at the crossroads. Also in this case, you should have one more point if an answer on SAARC comes, that even with respect to climate change, it is said when conferences are held, when leaders travel, a huge amount of fuel is wasted. It's not just only one leader traveling, it's a complete team traveling, and every travel results by air results in pollution. Plus in the conference also there is air conditioning, it's a huge preparation made, so all that results in expenditure too and results in pollution too, so contributing to climate change. So even Greta Thunberg who has been fighting against the team who has been fighting against climate change has also proposed that video conferencing should be held so that all this expenditure is eliminated and also climate change does not take place due to these additional polluting measures. And this is a crisis hit India at the crossroads. So this is regarding coronavirus pandemic, how it creates fresh possibilities for cooperation between West Asian nations and its neighbors. So SAARC is in South Asia, and here now we have in West Asia with Iran in under crisis and adjoining nations also suffering from coronavirus. So you can see, so this is a new challenge for Iran. Already the nuclear deal issue was there, and the rift between Iran and USA. Then on the op-ed page you have closing the gender gap in science. So this article says that very few women are in the science field, and the quality of science and advancement of society are both affected due to less number of women. So it proposes closing this gender gap means more women taking up science. And this is Miseries and Master Strokes. So this talks about how Bihar has slipped further on human development as Nitish Kumar is busy pursuing opportunistic politics. So this is a little political news too, you can skip it. And this is a problematic testing strategy. So this is regarding Kerala's rationale for revising its coronavirus testing guidelines. So this is as World Health Organization has urged countries that have reported many laboratory confirmed coronavirus cases to become more aggressive in testing. But India continues to have among the lowest testing rates in the world. So in India, only people with travel history to high risk coronavirus affected countries or with close contacts to laboratory confirmed cases and with symptoms of the disease are being tested. So that is called problematic. On March 12, Kerala Health Ministry also issued revised testing guidelines based on current risk assessment. And according to the guidelines, people with mild symptoms who have come from countries with ongoing coronavirus local transmission and contacts of confirmed suspect cases will not be tested for the virus. So mild symptoms will not be tested. So testing is not going to change either the clinical course or management of the patients with mild symptoms is what the guidelines says. So the rationale that testing people with mild symptoms that are non-specific would delay the testing of more deserving cases is problematic and may prove counterproductive. So this has been highlighted in this article. It is a very important point. On page 12 you have Lok Sabha passes appropriation bill. So Lok Sabha has passed the appropriation bill 2020-21, which is part of the budget comprised of two bills, appropriation bill and finance bill. So this bill has been passed, which empowers the government to draw over 110 lakh crore from the Consolidated Fund of India for its working, as well as for its implementation of its programs and schemes. On page 13, you have Ranjan Gogoi nominated to Rajya Sabha. So, former Chief Justice of India, who last resigned, Ranjan Gogoi, has now been nominated by President Ram Nath Kovind to Rajya Sabha. So, he retired in November 2019 and he headed the five-judge bench that delivered the verdict in Ayodhya case. He is now Rajya Sabha member. On international page, you have shutdown in Spain as virus spreads. So, more countries are imposing lockdowns and closing borders. And this is it is said the worst is still ahead of us. This is China to withdraw medical staff from Wuhan. So it says outbreak has almost seen an end there. So now there is no case in Wuhan as such. Then on business page you have, this is the front page news to how virus tightens grip and Indian indices also are at its lowest since September 2017. And this is RBI's focus on liquidity too. It says rate cut is an option for another day. So RBI, how it is responding to coronavirus too, it says it will not hesitate to deploy whatever measures it has to deal with coronavirus. It says we have an armory of weapons and we will not hesitate to deploy them. So, forex swap and a second long-term repo operations of 1 lakh crore, that are outlined for now are highlighted. Then you have, most airlines may fly into bankruptcy on coronavirus. So, this is Center for Aviation, which has said that as of now 145 countries have been affected by coronavirus and most airlines in the world will go bankrupt by the end of May 2020. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.